Hey everybody, this is Bass from Stoic Gaming with another episode of First Time Playing. Today we're going to be checking out Star Trek Online, which recently just had a huge expansion with the Romulan update. Legacy of Romulus, Romulan, whatever. So we're going to be checking it out. I have played this game before, I've never played it in depth. But I'm with my buddy Mitch here. Say hi, Mitch.
Hey, everybody.
So we are going to check this game out. Remember, Mitch is 6 seconds behind me since he's viewing the stream. So we are going to take a look at it. Currently, we are on the character creation screen. We have three different factions, which is different with the expansion. We have Starfleet, which is, Starfleet. We have the Romulan Empire and the Klingons. The Romulans are a new faction, and the Klingon was half-assed prior to this expansion, and both of those have been fleshed out into fully available factions at this point. So, as you can see, on the Starfleet side of the house, there is a retarded amount of different species that you can be. To include this little bald blue guy at the bottom down here, that is your own species. You could literally go in there and create your own species of alien, which is kind of neat. I usually pick one of the pre-mades, but let's see. So what do we got here for all the Trekkies out there? We got humans. If you play a human in this game, you are an idiot. I'm just gonna throw that out there.
Why is that?
Are you kidding me? Like, look at all these species, man, and you're gonna play a person. Andorians are one of my favorite Star Trek characters, or species, I should say. I love the Andorians, they're just awesome. But yeah, what else we got here? We got Bajoran. I'm not even sure. You know who Bajoran are? Any clue, Mitch? I'm probably not gonna know most of these races. Like,
No.
he looks like a human with an earring. Oh no, he's got some little weird nose things going on. Okay. We've got Benzites. I think I've seen them before. They kind of look like little blue fish people. That's great. We got Betazoid. This is what was the little telepath chick's name in Next Generation? Deanna Troi? It was Deanna Troi, wasn't it? Yeah, she was Betazoid. I think she was actually half Betazoid, half human. Some of my Star Trek viewers are gonna go apeshit on me in the comments. We've got a male Bolian. Well, they're all male. They've got female and male up here. We've got a Katian, cat people. We got Ferengi, another one of my favorite races. Ferengis are awesome, besides the fact that their heads look like giant butts. We've got Trill, joined Trill. I don't know what the hell that is either. We've got Klingon, Pakled. I haven't heard of half of these. You heard of Like, are you familiar with these, Mitch, at all?
No, I think most of these were in Next Generation, man.
Yeah,
I'm not that far.
we got Regelian. What else we got? What the hell is that? That looks like a Xaurian. That looks like something off of like Futurama. We've got Tellarite. There's your obligatory short race that every game needs. We've got Trill. So there was Join Trill and Trill. I'll get into what these little gold coins are in a second. We've got Vulcan. Everybody knows what Vulcan is. And then the custom alien race. So that's everything for this for Starfleet. Any of these that you see that's got the little gold Z on it is a Perfect World game. Cryptic and Perfect World like merged or one bought out the other. I don't know what the hell happened, but they use a currency across these games called Zen. So basically, if you wanted to be a joined Trill or a Klingon in Starfleet, you would have to pay for it to unlock it, and it's like 500 Zen, which is probably like $5 or some shit. Anywhere from like 500 to 1,000 out of what I've seen. So, I mean, that's pretty good. There's looks like, what is there, like 20 races here, and only two of them you gotta pay for? Like, looks pretty good to me. So then next we
You
got
could
the
create
next
your
we got
own.
the and you could create your own. I wonder if you could create a Klingon. You're like, I want a Klingon and I ain't paying for this shit. You could just go in there and create a Klingon. All right, we have the Romulan Empire now. They only have three races available to them. They've got Custom Alien, which is this dude. They've got the Reeman, and they've got the Romulans. This one's got a little green check mark on it because I paid for the Reeman. My other character that I've been dicking around with is a Reeman, and I just wanted something that everybody else didn't have, so I paid for it. And he is an ugly SOB. But and there's a the Ramen guy. So yeah, three races. Remember, the Ramen faction is new. So now we got the Klingon faction. It's got Klingons. We've got blue cat people. We've got lizard people. We got, what is this, the Argonian, and what are the what were the cat people in
the Khajiit?
The Khajiit and Argonians right here. Tell me that's not the fucking Khajiit and the Argonians. All right, we've got Join Trill. I wonder if you unlock it up for the Starfleet, if it unlocks under the Klingons too. We have got, what the hell is that? I'm not quite sure what I'm looking at. That's a Lethian? Sure. We've got another big word. That looks like Predator. We've got bald green guy.
Has entered channel.
We got bald green guy that basically looks like a human that's green with no hair. What's going on, Resonate? How's it going?
Yo, yo.
We're doing first time playing for Star Trek Online.
Mm.
And we've got this little weird blue bearded thing. So what do you think? We're going to go Klingon, because I've never done Klingon, Mitch. What do you want to see? Should we make a race?
We should make a race.
All right. Oh, this is the alien one, so we're going to make a race then. So let's go. We're going to go next. No! Back. I think we... No, this is it. This is it. We're there. So, we've got to pick armor. It doesn't seem to have a lot of choices. We've got battle armor, we've got ceremonial armor, scarlet armor, and stealth. This is going to change throughout the game anyways. We are going to pick... Well, battle armor looks kind of cool. Ah, ceremonial. I like ceremonial armor. How tall should we make this dude? Should we make him a giant or a midget? Or somewhere in the middle. 4'6". We can make him a midget. I want a little Napoleon guy. What do you think?
I would agree with that.
Yeah. Make
Let's
him a little,
go shorty.
Like, evil genius midget type guy. We'll make him super short. Alright, head.
He's gotta be bald.
He has to be bald. Like, that's a not option. He's definitely... We got humanoid head. Let's zoom in on his melon here. We got ridged. We can give him like a cone head. We can give him... Look like somebody hit him with a shovel. He'll catch up here in like 2 seconds. We got smooth nose. What the hell? And we got smooth nose with a ridge. Oh, smooth nose just means it's got a really fucking wide nose. That's a really odd head shape they got going here. I think a normal humanoid head is going to be fine. Well, we could probably pick one of these things on the right to get like a... Whoa, look at this dude's ears. We're going to start off with that guy. But we're going to change overall pattern. Oh, wow. We could... This is insane. There's a lot of stuff you could do to this dude. I think I want him to have patterns. Patterns are kind of weird. We got complexions. Ooh, you want to make him fishy looking? I got like a tree bark one. I mean, he's alien. He shouldn't look
That's
human,
straight up
right?
Tree bark.
That was tree bark, right? Oh, you want to make a Sith? I got to fix them ears.
You can do that?
I don't know. We're going to make him look like a fucking...
Don't they have like tentacles and stuff hanging off their chins and face?
They do. I wonder if they've got... They got every type of elf ear known to man. No, they don't have... I can vent his head. That's kind of crazy looking. No, I can't do tentacles. I could make a night elf. No ears is kind of cool. Hairstyle.
Well, that's creepy.
No, and what, the no ears?
Yeah.
Eyebrows. No, I want him to be hairless. Mouth accessory? Kind of. We could make a dwarf, dude. You want to make a fucking dwarf?
Yeah.
Alright, we gotta change it back to a more...
Dwarvenator.
We're gonna make Dwarvenator. Alright, we need to skin color. We need to get him back more to dwarf colored. Eyes. He's still got some crazy ass forehead thing going on. Holy crap, his nose is flat. There we go. How'd I get them ridges in his head? Forehead detail. Holy crap, there's a crap ton of forehead detail. You could make a Klingon. Look at this shit.
I saw that. You can.
I could just make my own Klingon. Screw your fucking charging me for this shit. We'll give him some, like, subtle ridges like that. Oh, shit, he's got no ears. Dwarfs definitely have ears. Alright, mouth accessory. He gets epic beard. That's the name of his freaking mouth accessory. Epic beard. Head attach organic. Oh, you can give him, like, spines and horns and all types of shit. Antenna. Alright, let's look at his body. His overall head size needs to be fairly large, considering he's a midget, a dwarf, right? Probably make his head width a little bigger, too.
Space dwarf here.
Head depth? What's head depth? I don't think he needs all that head depth. Neck bulk? We'll bulk up his neck. This guy's got to be chunky. Conehead. I need to get to... The face is fine. I don't give a fuck. We can play with all that later. Where's the body? Scaling. There's gotta be bodies. Oh, body. Here we go. Looks a little more dwarfish. I still think his arms are too long, though. He's got a hell of a gut, man. How's that? You think he looks like a dwarf?
Wow. Yeah, I'd say so.
Alright. What else can we change? Uniform. We can get a little more in depth with it. Ooh, the sleeveless thing looks kind of cool.
That might be as close as you can get.
To a dwarf?
Yeah, man.
We get planar gauntlets. Alright. He gets. Get that belt a little lower on his waist. What's this? His pants? And boots. We'll go with those. Oh, that's not what I want. Those look like superhero boots. We'll just go with regular padded boots. Fuck it. Alright, we got a dwarf. We're gonna save this outfit. And we're going to background. And her name. Oh, we're gonna randomize this shit.
Dwarvenator is not good enough?
You wanna do Dwarvenator?
Oh, unless random can do something better.
Let's see what we got. Bifu. Severpy. Zuli. Zingava.
Did someone say Dwarvenator?
Yeah. Hey, how's it going? I made a dwarf in Star Trek.
What?
Star Trek Online. Go watch the stream, dude. We're trying to figure out what to name my dwarf.
Are you done with the recording?
No, we're still recording.
Oh. How long is this recording?
I don't know. I usually do like an hour. I'm bored.
So am I allowed to talk normally, or...
Yeah, you could talk.
Like, is this formal recording?
No.
I mean, yeah, I fucked it up, if
no,
that's the case, but...
We shoot the shit in here all the time. I just don't want anybody else coming in here and, like, playing video games and shit. That's the only reason that the fucking Mumble channel is labeled like that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What about ZoiWow? Mitch? You like ZoiWow? We should name him not a dwarf.
That works.
So I took this pre-workout tonight for the first time, and this shit is crazy.
You took what out?
Pre-workout.
Yeah, how'd that work out for you?
I went from being tired, you know, like drowned after work, like bleh, to fucking let's work. It was like meth in a bottle, pretty much.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Your ship name is Iron Forge.
Iron Forge.
It let me make him. His name is not a freaking dwarf. His bio is from somewhere other than Azeroth.
In a galaxy far, far away.
Yeah. We're members of the Klingon
that too.
Faction. Yeah.
Just screw up all the freaking lore.
Oh, this is obviously an old CG movie for the game. They didn't remake. The Klingon one looked a lot nicer.
This is about the same people as Neverwinter, isn't it?
Cryptic, yeah. Cryptic makes this.
Yeah, I haven't played Neverwinter in a long time.
Yeah. It's only been out for like... It's not even out yet. It's not even out of open beta yet. You haven't played it in a long time. I guess, yeah, Charlie, when this game came out, it was, it was freaking... The good guys. Who were they? Starfleet? And then there was, like... Once you beat the game... I say beat the game. End game, I guess. Made it to end game. You would unlock the ability to make a Klingon character, right? And... There was, like, no Klingon game. It wasn't fleshed out. It was horrible, right? So that was years ago, and they just recently came out with the Romulan update. They added a Romulan faction and completely fleshed out the Klingon faction. And completely redid the UI from scratch and all type. It buffed up the graphics a little bit and all that shit.
Nice.
Yeah, so I've been dicking around with some of my other friends, and it's pretty fun. It ain't bad. Welcome to Star Trek Online. And the tutorial gets annoying. Shut up.
Alright,
we'll
I'll
figure
be right
it
back.
Out. Yep. Alright. I'm the second officer. He even runs like a dwarf. Holy crap, look how much taller this dude is than me, dude.
You're like half his height.
Yeah, dude. That's just not a good height to be.
But you command great respect nonetheless.
Alright, let's talk to this dude. Shut up, tutorial lady. I recommend approving them and the records of battle before. Yes, sir. Everything awaiting your approval is on the console to the right of the main view screen.
You have completed a task by.
Boopity boopity, bippity boopity. Oh, I gotta go back and talk to this dude. I see the logs are updated and approved. Voiced over, that's pretty cool. To make some adjustments to the standard disruptor target practice program
on the holodeck. I think you'll enjoy the. Was that in it originally?
No, I don't. I'm not voiceovers? Sure. I don't think. I think there was some, but not nearly as many. Like the Romulan stuff's like pretty much all voiced over, and it looks like this was all redone too. Approach the captain. That's this dude. How about I just double click on him? That works. I see you kept my ship from blowing up during the night watch. Get to the racks as soon as you can. You can punch too, see? Hiya! Hiya! You got like the Captain Kirk fucking palm, upward palm move. Going to a holodeck. The mini map shows you where your objectives are. An arrow will appear on the mini map if you are far away from your. Programming the holodeck. Move to the center of the room and then target and destroy 5 holotargets.
In combat, right click on a target to fire your weapon.
It's an Argonian, kill him!
Can you like take cover and stuff?
Is that cover? Does that work? While in combat, certain actions are disabled. Once you drop out of. Oh yeah, watch this. I forgot about this. Hold on, if I can. You can go into like total first person mode. Why am I in like, I'm in some kind of, oh, there we go. Yeah, now I'm in like total first person mode, and you can press X and go into like complete first person mode. So that's different. That's like, what's this want me to do? Oh, nothing. It's just lights. Learn more about combat practice again. No, I'm good. It never asked me to name my race, did it?
Not that I know of.
That's kind of weird. It would have been nice to name it.
Did you pick your ship yet?
No, no. I think they auto-assign you your first ship. They might give you a choice of a couple different ones, I'm not sure. Later that day.
Dude, do you ever hop on League any- or, Eve anymore?
No, I haven't hopped on Eve in a while. Do you still play Eve?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's cool. You must be fucking hooked up by now.
I can fly battle cruisers.
That's cool.
Yeah, actually.
Oh, shit!
Shields, rain shields! Battle stations! All crew, battle stations!
The Enterprise just showed up and fucked some shit up.
So you're on the opposite side of the Enterprise, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm on the Klingon faction.
Like you're the bad guys?
I guess that's a matter of who you ask.
Perspective.
Yeah. I'm not even a Klingon, I'm like talking shit to all these Klingons. I don't know why they take my fucking... I'm 3 feet tall. Come up. You're alive. This is First Officer Gerard. That's great. Congratulations, warrior. I'm now level one. Get a rifle from the armory locker. Oh, there it is. Oh, look, I got one of those melee things. The freaking big curved blade things. You can switch between two equipped weapons by pressing Z. I'm gonna go fuck shit up with this thing. Look, it's bigger than I am, dude. Look at this shit. Oh yeah, I forgot there's double tap to dodge. Get out of that mode. I don't know if this is a very good idea to be fighting with this thing.
Don't be a pussy.
I'm whipping out my blaster rifle.
Were you standing in fire?
Yeah.
That's Brett's a bone, man.
It's a buff! I swear to God, I read somewhere it was a buff.
I'm pretty sure the only fight where you're ever supposed to stand in fire was the Twilight Council.
Twilight Council?
You remember that?
Yeah.
We fight the four dudes at once.
Wasn't it purple fire? It wasn't even like normal fire.
Mm-mm. This is normal fire.
Was it?
Mm-hmm. Did you get it? You did it to get this water debuff off you.
I don't remember. It was a long time
ago. What the hell was the name of that raid, though?
The...
Like the Twilight Tower or something?
No, it was the big, huge tower. It was a tower, but it was called,
Twilight Pinnacle.
No, that wasn't it, was it?
I don't know.
That doesn't sound right either. I don't remember.
Oh, no, I'm thinking of the Vortex Pinnacle.
Yeah.
That's one.
Twilight's been the name of it, I think.
I don't think so, too.
Die.
I had so much fun in WoW during that expansion. Like, yeah. At least the beginning of it.
Yeah. I did too. And then they tried to get me to do the same fucking quest over and over 150 times. I said, no, sir.
Oh my god, dude. Did you ever make it to 90 when we played again for that short period of time?
No, god, no. I got to like, dude. 48, I think, or some shit. I gotta hit
literally, in order to raid, you had to do dailies because it gave you like these tokens to get the gear and looking for raid.
That's horrible.
Yeah. It was so fucking frustrating. I was like, I don't want to do dailies. Like,
yeah, no, that's horrible. Dailies should be optional. Look, the console and the picture's even smashed. That's pretty cool. You recovered that message from the Federation borders? My suspicions about our... Shut up, Klingon hooker. Hey, look, there's a dude in jail. Just kicking it. I gotta get off the ship so I can do some of the space combat. Federation prisoner. Oh, I gotta talk to the dude now. Come here. That was a weird glitch. I saw space for a second.
First off, this is Captain Jurlek.
Space.
It is the Final Frontier. So they say.
I haven't seen the new one. Did you see it?
The second one? No, I haven't seen it yet.
It was alright.
Was it as good as the first one?
I like the villain better.
The first one was pretty fucking awesome.
I thought the first one was pretty epic, yeah. Alright, that's enough of that. Thanks, Baldum. I don't talk to you. What the hell? If that better be enough of that, I'm getting shot at.
Hey man, DayZ is gonna alpha, like the actual standalone game is gonna start in June.
Oh really? That's tomorrow.
Yeah.
Well, it's tomorrow.
I mean, like
for
sometime
me.
In June.
Yeah.
They said.
Is the alpha gonna be available? He's doing it like Minecraft did it, right? And what does his thing?
Yeah.
So you'll be able to buy into the alpha like cheaper than buying the game?
Yeah. Okay. I highly recommend doing
it. Oh, did I tell you what my wife, what I ordered this morning? My wife totally said it was okay.
What's, oh, I saw on Facebook.
Did you see it?
You lucky dog.
What am I doing
here? You lucky dog.
Get to the bridge. Yeah. I don't know how I convinced her that that was a good idea. Well, because I had been planning on getting 2 670s. That was the plan. And I've convinced her that $650 was much cheaper than $800, plus a new case so I could fit 2 graphics cards in there. So I was like, 650 is way cheaper than 1,000. She's like, yeah, I guess that's true. I was like, yeah, look at the big picture. $1,000 over the next 6 months, or 650 like tomorrow. Anyways, it's in the mail.
I'd be excited.
Yeah, I had to get a PNY though, because the other ones were like sold out all over the fucking place. I tried to get the I want a EVGA. All I could find was either Galaxy or PNY, and I settled on PNY. But they're both spec cards. They're both standard spec cards. They don't do anything special to them. Where the fuck is the bridge? As opposed to like Gigabyte and EVGA do a lot of overclocking and like change the fucking fan, the cooler on it and shit like that. The Galaxy card and the PNY card are straight built off the specs that NVIDIA hands out. Minus the sticker on it, they're probably literally identical. The fuck do you get to the bridge? There it is.
And I mean, you've got an i7. It's like it's gonna be, what, 2 generations old?
Yeah, it's fine. I got a i7-950. But I can overclock the dog shit out of it, so...
When do they come out? What's the new one called? There's Ivy Bridge, then it's... What?
I don't remember.
It's not a bridge, it's like...
Sandy Bridge was before Ivy, something or other.
It's like Goodwill or something like that.
Yeah, I'm kind of waiting until they got something past like an i9. Then I'll do like a whole motherboard upgrade. Because I'm still rocking 12 gigabytes of 1600 RAM.
No, there has
more than fine. Haswell? You said Goodwill.
Hey man, I was close. We're going off memory and not looking at this shit for a while.
Yeah, I mean...
Real close.
If you want a sweater, you can go to Goodwill.
I said Goodwill.
Oh, I thought you said Goodwill.
Haswell, or Goodwill. It's Haswell.
Alright, is this the bridge? This is a horrible... There's no chairs or nothing here.
That's like the next like leap in technology. It's not like just from like a minor upgrade like from Sandy to Ivy Bridge.
Yeah.
So
that's
I'm
like
probably
a huge
getting
huge
it.
One.
Yeah.
Well, you need it more than I do. Like you're still rocking the AMD.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got a job,
so
right? You're still working at the fucking place with the camping stuff. Holy crap!
Yeah,
they're all
dude.
Coming in at the elevator after me.
I love that job, but our hours are getting cut. Thanks a lot, Obama.
Thanks a lot, Obama. He's the reason my computer case isn't big enough to fit 2 graphics cards.
Thanks, Obama.
I don't even got a problem with him. Like, whatever, all politicians are idiots, but I heard it's the current meme to blame him, so that's what I'm doing.
No, but see, like, some, I don't know if it's Obama, but some fucking politicians are fucking up.
Oh,
you know what's going
can
on?
Can you find me one that's not?
I don't know. I'm not into politics. I just know.
Oh, shit, I
should have
read
me.
This. My captain just attacked me.
fucking, basically, I don't know if you heard about this because it doesn't affect you, but anyone, you know how normally it's the law was anyone that works 40 hours or above has to have benefits?
Yeah.
They're changing it to anyone that works 30 hours or above has to have benefits. So they were like, oh yeah, well everyone will get benefits, blah 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 blah.
That's good. Nope. You want benefits? No, they're just gonna fire you.
They're not. They're just cutting our hours and hiring more people.
That's pretty obvious.
Yeah, and that's happening like to everyone, not just fucking.
Yeah, that's crazy.
It's not like an isolated incident with the company I work for.
Yeah.
So hopefully Congress will get their shit together and reverse this
damn bill. Yeah, that was somebody who should have made a fucking law or something. There could have been a clause in that law. That's a good law, like, let's try and give people benefits, but that's a blatant loophole in the law, you know what I mean?
I understand what the fuck they were trying to do, but, like, really?
Way to fuck it up.
Yeah.
Good in theory.
Fucking, that's like, ugh,
goddamn. That's the story of Congress, man. Come up with a good idea and then fucking destroy it on the way out the door.
Yeah. See, like, for me, I don't give a fuck about benefits. I'm still covered under my dad's shit.
Yeah.
Like, tell him, like,
I got TRICARE, I'm gonna fuck.
Tell him, I don't know. How old is, are you eligible under your parents?
I think 26 or some shit.
Yeah. And I'm 20.
Hey, I got a ship. I'm in space. Kagan has joined your crew. Ooh, and I got a first mate. Yeah, Mitch, how you doing?
Yeah, absolutely.
Dude,
I just gotta
look at
up.
My warbird, man.
Sorry, me and Brett can kind of...
We battle a lot. That's a pretty cool ship, man. What do I gotta do? W and S to move. I know how to move my damn ship. Dun, dun, dun. How does this game got awesome, like, in-game flight, but somehow Star Wars The Old Republic fucked that up? There's no way that this game had a bigger budget than Star Wars did.
EA, man. EA.
Had to be.
Fuck. I'm versus Thresh. Goddamn Thresh Prince.
Oh, we got a scan for Iridium. Alright, we're gonna go over there and look for some iridium. Use your mini map or press M to see where your next objective is. Yep, press M. Sir, I recommend using full impulse to reach the asteroid. I'm already using the home slice. Activate full impulse by clicking. Held, full stop! Sir, I stopped the ship this time. You know what, Mitch? I don't think I could play a Klingon because I can't stand the, like, ghetto-ass Klingon accent in my ear the whole time.
Sir, I've stopped a full stop on a ship.
Drive me fucking crazy, man. Found several asteroids that contain iridium, Captain. Weapons are back online. Press the space bar to...
I need some jams.
Hey Mitch, you see the blue circle around the bird?
Yeah.
Those are your shields, right? So where the green bird is down there, you can like divert power to certain shields as they're getting like front, back, left, or right as they're getting destroyed and stuff. That's a really cool part of space combat. So if you're getting blasted on the right side and your right shield starts kind of going down, they got super names like Starbird and Port Side and all that shit, but if your right shield starts going down, you can just click this little right button or click the right arrow on your keyboard and you'll divert power to the right fucking, the right shield and stuff, and it'll slowly take it off the other ones and spread it back out. It's pretty cool.
Good concept.
Yeah, it works pretty good in practice. Talk to first officer. Captain, I'm picking up a Starfleet distress signal. Seems that a frigate looking for us took a hit in a nearby asteroid field. They are disabled. Might I... Your order, sir. Approach and destroy the disabled frigate. Really? I guess we're Klingons, that's the type of shit we do, right? See how his like shields on that side have turned yellow, they turn red.
Yellow,
they
turn red.
And you have certain weapons that can only be shot from certain. You can get like a forward cannon and a backward cannon. Oh. Or you got some stuff that's got complete 360, like phasers have 360. Or you got like torpedo bays and stuff that can only shoot in certain directions. Holy shit, I'm gonna die. Oh no, I'm not. What happened? I'm good.
Divert power to main shields.
Yeah. I can't do it, Captain. I don't have the power. That's right. Never fuck around with a dwarf, bitches. Oh, there's classes too, and I think I skipped over that. There's the three classes are engineer, science officer, and tactical. That's nice. Prepare your cloaking device. How awesome is that? The Romulans actually have better cloaking than the Klingons do, but. And you take damage if you're too close to a ship when it blows up. Like that. I gotta say, the space combat in the game really is satisfying. Like, it's. I don't. They did a really good job with the space combat. Dude's dead. He's dead. Well, then, I am command of the Iron Forge now.
I'll cut you the same deal I had with Jurlek.
Get your order, sir.
You're making a huge mistake.
What, are you gonna blow her up? No. Oh, yep, I think we are.
Disable torpedo by clicking on the... How your torpedo will increase the power of your next torpedo.
Oh, the Musashi's going down, dude. Oh, I need to fucking divert some power to my shields. Shit. My forward shields are almost fucked. I guess they just turn around. Out of shield. This guy needs to hurt him and die. Three. Done. Oh shit, I need to get out of here. This is gonna hurt. Nope. Not bad though. That wasn't close enough. Most missions can be turned. Romulan ships freaking explode when they go up, like, it sends out a shockwave and hurts everybody. You catch all that, Mitch?
Say that again?
No, did you catch that whole fight?
Yeah.
Space battle's pretty badass. And when it comes to PvP and stuff too, and everybody's flying around with all different types of ships and modifications and upgrades and...
Jesus.
Look, the warping. It looks like Star Trek... It looks like Star Trek warping. I don't know, I like the game a lot. I like the game a lot.
I'm gonna play it.
Yeah.
I'm starting to download it.
What do you wanna be? I'll make a new character. I haven't played any character super serious.
It'll take me a while, and I got work in the morning.
Well, yeah, I'm just saying factions
in
general.
I'll probably Starfleet though.
Starfleet? I'm kind of still leaning towards Andorians. Well, we've kind of, this episode's about done it. We've done space combat. We did running around, ground combat, all that kind of good stuff. So I guess we'll wrap up this episode of FTP. This was Star Trek Online. I highly, highly, highly recommend this game, especially being free to play. It's got a pretty decent free to play model. It's got PvP. It's got space combat. It's got ground combat. This is definitely an MMO I could see somebody playing as a primary MMO. So until next time, this was Baz. Resonate was here. Mitch was here. This is Star Trek Online.
Yeah, buddy.
You guys take it easy.